You are God. We give you honor and praise.
It is better to fast in the afternoon than to fast in the morning. I just shocked people. For you to fast from 6 to 12, it's normal. Because many days you go to lectures without food. You know, many of you use the lecture period to fast. I'm fasting today. But it's your normal activity. I told someone, eat anything you want to eat from 6 a.m. up until 3 p.m. But don't eat from 3 p.m. to the next day. The person looked at me and said, it's easy. It's easy. I said, no problem. Glory be to God. It's easy. 11 p.m., I received a call. Pastor, this is no easy. I can't sleep. I said, hey, you can't sleep. Why? Because I need to eat. I said, yes, now we are getting to know the problem to you having some weird dreams. You see, there are some people that cannot eat until Banku is in the stomach. So all the food they eat is Banku influenced. And tell me what you will be able to hear when your system is balkanized. Now, I know many of you will look at me, but when you study the Bible, you will come to a place where Paul himself said, even some that their belly is their God. Their belly is their God. That means their belly affairs determine a lot that happens in their life. I said, so brother, you cannot. He said, my system is already used to that. If I don't eat and I'm not full, I cannot sleep. I said, that's the reason I gave you this special fast. The first day was difficult for him. Third day, fourth day, fifth day. He said something. He said, Pastor, one thing I noticed that some strange dreams I used to dream, they ceased. And the things I see in the dream now, they are pure, they are clean, they are this. What happened? I said, no, it's not that God changed. It's just that you changed. But because God has always remained the same. Do you know why I'm sharing this with you? Your dreams, what affects and influences your dream can be traced to what the last activity, the 2 hours last activity you did before you slept. What you were thinking, what you were talking, what you were watching. If you are watching where they are chasing people, in the dream, it's either they are chasing you or you are chasing. But one thing I'm sure, there must be a chasing. So, can I say something to you? Fasting is not just not eating. But we need to understand fasting. Fasting simply means an action that we take to shut down the physicalities so that our spirit man can be well connected to what God wants us to do. So I realized that when I want to connect to God effectively, there are certain things I need to do. There are some men of God that I know, they don't eat after 6 p.m. I'm not saying you should follow religion, but they pray from 6 p.m. if they're not doing anything. La Croix Shaker. I met one of them when Apostle Johnson Suleiman came. One of the pastors that he doesn't eat after. He will come down, you give him food, he doesn't eat. All you'll be hearing from his room, Le Mokoto Parani Moshikoto Prabokoto. He will pray to you the next day. And then those kind of men, you go to them and say, release that, give me anointing, give me anointing. I tap from you. My dear, you can tap that anointing very well, but you don't have the lifestyle to maintain that anointing. That is something people don't understand. You can tap anointing from anywhere, but you need that dimension of lifestyle to maintain some frequency of anointing. My God, I even saw somebody say, they are so in tune with God. So in tune with God. When last did you pray? When last did you fast? I will leave it here. I just said this to challenge you. Do you know that many of you have the key to the change you are looking for? Probably you have prepared the food right now at home. As you are getting home, you say, Lord, I'm tiring. You see, some people start laughing. They're like, Pastor, don't you just leave it. We'll start tomorrow. We already prepared for today. I know that's what some of you say, Pastor, just leave today. You don't understand. We already have not eaten since today. You are telling me to go home and tarry. Just, we'll do it tomorrow. Hallelujah. You know, I love you guys, right? And it will not be nice that I hide some of these things from you. What makes you tick as a believer are the things that you observe that helps you to be connected spiritually. They are very important. How you pray, how you fast, how you eat. Ask the pastors around me, ask the coordinators. If I add small weight like this, I know you are eating, no? But if I tell you what I eat, many of you is just appetizer. Warm up. But can I say something to you? You actually need a kind of lifestyle to maintain a kind of anointing. Anointing is not by a fizzy. It's not by dressing well. You need a prayer life that is sustained by fasting, and you need the studying of the word. You are God. We give you honor and praise.